How you doing, YouTube? Matt Massive Beer Reviews back with a little papaya up in this piece in the form of their I Know You Like Them Hot Extra Hoppy. I almost said just hoppy. It's extra hoppy. This is a double IPA, 8% alcohol by volume. I'd call it that. Yes, hazy double India Pale Ale on the back, it says. What you're holding is a Pariah Double IPA featuring intense kettle and dry hopping doses of deliciously tropical American hops. We get aromas of pungent, earthy citrus accompanied by rich expressions of papaya, melon, mandarin orange, and stone fruit on the palate. I know you like extra hoppy as a result of our continuous refinement towards intensely flavorful yet balanced beers. This was canned 7/26, which would make this beer just about 2 weeks old. Comes directly from Pariah. Let's drink it. Yeah, let's see what the sucker has to offer. Look-wise, that's a turbid. Turbid hazy right there. Yeah, we're getting close to turkey gravy on this one. Label-wise, it's bubble. I know you like them extra hoppy. It looks like there's a bunch of hops, but I'm missing something here. There's like a hamburger bun and burger under. Is it like a sloppy? Oh, I know you like them extra sloppy. It's a sloppy Joe. It's the thing. It's the sloppy Joe or sloppy Joe to that guy. Who's that guy? Adam Sandler? Yeah, that's what it is. That's got to be it. I think it's the first time I got like a random reference sometimes. Like totally like space on it. So I know you like them extra sloppy. Is that. Or is that Billy Madison? It's confusing because I don't remember if it was Billy Madison. A scene from Billy Madison or a scene from the video for Sloppy Joe's. Anyway, there you go. I got it. So label-wise, all right. It's dark. That's turbid. Like, that's the thing. That beer's not dark. That beer is actually quite bright and quite light. But since it's so dense and so turbid, it looks way darker than it actually is. Pinky finger white is white could be. Head, just pulpy orange juice. The nose. I mean, there's not a huge nose here. 8%, you expect something a little bit more impactful. It's definitely got this kind of chunky, kind of OJ kind of thing, but there's not a big sweetness to it. The last two Pariah beers I reviewed was quite a while ago, a few months ago. And both of them really were hit with a decently impactful kind of carbonic acid. I think I caught those even on the nose going, I think this is like a carbonic acid thing. I'm not really getting that in the nose here. What I'm getting is this kind of restrained kind of density in this beer. Citrus is in there, but it's nothing close to what you'd expect from a 6 or 8% kind of super turbid hazy. It comes off as more of this kind of just like rich, dense kind of sneak boxy. Even sneak boxes bigger nose than this. It's a soft citrus on the nose, but you smell a density and aggressiveness in the beer. So let's dive in. Cheers. That's interesting. There's still that carbonic thing going on. Decently hefty in this beer also. But there's this really kind of... It's not saccharine-y sweet kind of sweetness. It's sugary. It's like kind of refined sugary kind of sweetness that kind of almost tries to beat that back a bit. It's a weird beer. Yeah. It's a little too just kind of convoluted. Like it actually has a soft mouthfeel, but immediately turns thin. It has that pop of that citrus sweetness, but then it comes like a refined sugar sweetness. There's a bittering that melts into a carbonic thing. So it really does start off as quite a positive beer for me. But then it just kind of slides into this kind of like disconjoined kind of thing going on. It's not a horrible beer. It's not. But there's something about it. It's the way it kind of... I actually explained it. I shouldn't even have to explain it any further. It keeps it together. Let's find the analogy for this one. So they're moving to the East Coast, but from San Diego. So let's do this for the San Diego peeps. This beer drinks exactly like the San Diego Chargers. Because do San Diego Chargers still exist? No, they're not. They're the LA Chargers. You know what I'm talking about. And that they can hold it together for like three quarters. half a game, three quarters, and then it's the fourth quarter, it's like they just fall apart. That's kind of where this beer comes to a point, is that it has all these really fun kind of bits and pieces to it. Initially, I like the hopping and the mouthfeel, and that little pop of sweetness is actually kind of cool. But then it just kind of goes on its own path, dissipates, and each one of those flavors becomes a singular thing that doesn't add up to something that's really great. But it does. If it kept the course, if all that stuff stayed cohesive throughout the beer, I think it'd be an absolutely killer beer. And Prize can do that, man. They have crushed some of these hazies, single double IPAs. Just this one is a little bit more disjointed than I like, especially towards the end. Now, like I said, the last two I had from them really wasn't my cup of tea. This is quite a bit better for me than what those were, but it still has some ways to go. It's a weird thing, you know? I mean, breweries kind of ebb and flow and go in different directions over the course of their life. And you know, the good ones, you know, shift to, maybe it's just my palate, maybe it's just something that I'm not privy to or like in a beer. And they're shifting in a direction that they want to go and other people enjoy. More often than not, these breweries kind of circle around and come back to something, whether it be a learning curve, trying something different brew system, yada, yada, yada. There's good in here. And it's just a little bit disjointed towards the end, like I said. So, yeah. Is this one of the better double IPAs I've had as late? No. Valued availability, it's San Diego's double IPA, probably $18 to $20 a 4-pack, brewery owned, and then leave you with, if you like what we like this. If you like big hazies, you're not susceptible to carbonic acid. That kind of tempers a lot of the flavor here. So if something that you don't detect, and that's the thing, a lot of people aren't affected by it, then you probably really dig this beer. But if you're like me, and, you know, some of these brewers that have gotten down this path, you know, like the Trillium as of late, I can't really do much of their beer. So if that's the way you feel about Trillium, it might not be your thing. But if you're like, Trillium's still awesome, there you go. Beer for you. So hopefully you guys enjoyed our review. Down there if you want to talk about it. Massive Beers if you want to check me out doing the social media stuff. Beer Massif if you want to check me out doing the whole podcasting thing. Hopefully you guys enjoyed our review. Hopefully enjoying a little pariah right now. Hope to see you next time. Cheers.